Hi, and welcome to the Presentation Skills Training Workshop. My name is David McQueen. I am a TV presenter and speaker, and I'm excited to be working with FirstGive to deliver this presentation skills program to you. Through this workshop, you'll be able to learn some amazing skills that will help you to design and deliver your presentation. In addition, you'll be learning how to master your nerves. Now, you will need to be using your student workbook, which will help you with your professional development, as well as a team planning workbook, which you will use together to be able to build and deliver your presentation. I am really looking forward to seeing you deliver your presentations. When you're having a conversation, it's not just about the verbal, it's not just about the words you're saying, but it's also about your visual communication, what you're doing with your eyes, your hands, your whole body language. Think about it as friends. When you're talking, and say, for example, there may be somebody you don't like, and that person walks past when you're in a conversation, your whole body language might be like, and you don't even have to say anything. Or say, for example, an adult is telling you off, and they're speaking to you. You might be standing with your arms crossed or rolling your eyes, and you don't have to say anything, but your body language says, I'm not really interested in this conversation. Now, I don't want to focus on the negative. I want to show you how you can use your visual communication to positively make sure that your presentation has impact. Now, take, for example, if you've gone to a performance, it could be theatrical or musical, and you're watching a person on stage, and that person on stage has got your attention, but not only are you watching that person, but the other people to the side as well. And while you're watching that performance, the person to the side might be acting like this. And again, you might be focusing on the person on the other side who might be doing something like that. Now, that will distract you. What you really want to do when you're giving a presentation as a group is not make those mistakes, but you want to be acting like this or like this. And this is how important it is to ensure that you and your team are doing the right things visually in order to make sure that your presentation has impact. I want to talk to you about gestures, how you use your hands when you're making a presentation. Now, your history teachers may not have told you this, but a lot of wars and conflicts have started just because of gestures. What I want to show you is how you can use those gestures appropriately. For example, you will realize that politicians don't point at people when they want to say something. What they will do is they will clasp their thumb just at the top of their hand like this, and when they are pointing at the audience, they will make sure it's not a pointed finger, but a whole fist, so that it's not confrontational. Likewise, when you are trying to get people to warm to your presentation and warm to what it is that you're saying, open gestures, wide open arm gestures, are about making sure that people know that you're not threatening them, but you want them on side. So think about the gestures you want to use in your presentation. Don't be wild and exaggerated. Don't stick your hands in your pockets. Just make sure that they are appropriate and open. One of the greatest tools that you can have as a presenter is your power stance. This is where you stand with your feet shoulder length apart, with your back straight and your shoulders slightly arched. And you stand and you speak with authority and power, and you feel epic. Now, I want to talk about a part of presenting that a lot of people have a problem with, and that's eye contact. Now, whether that's because you're scared or whether it's cultural, people do tend to have issues with eye contact, but I want to be able to help you with this. Now, I'm sure you have seen a number of presentations where people have great content, but instead of looking at you, they're looking up to the sky. Or, even worse, they're looking down to the ground and not giving you any eye contact. And I suppose the one that probably freaks people out the most is that person who's presenting but staring straight at you with their eyes wide open, looking like a stalker. But there are ways that you can actually deal with eye contact. There are some simple tips that can make sure that when you're presenting, you can use eye contact to your benefit. So the first one I'm going to tell you is when you're in a room, divide the room into four. And you can look to the front, to the back on that side, and to the front here. And what you do is when you're presenting, you take your time and you present to those four areas without staring for too long, but just glancing over, and you keep good eye contact. The second one is that you can actually look at somebody just above their brow. Rather than looking at them straight in their eye and you and that person feel uncomfortable, just look just above their brow. That way, it's not about you being intimidated or being scared by having good eye contact, but making sure that you give the appearance that you're actually looking at that person.
Do to my sign?
I wrote the same, but in different words.
Thanks, love.
Now, you would have seen from your assembly that First Give are passionate about you being as creative as possible in your presentation for your chosen charity. Here is an opportunity for you to be able to use drama and poetry and music and comedy and in an appropriate sense to be able to get the message across as powerfully as you want it to be. Now, when you get together and you work together in your teams and you're using your team planning workbooks, here is where you can go all out on a limb. Think about how you want to use social media, how you really want to be able to get a story told through your drama where you are demonstrating everything that you've learned from your gestures, your eye contact, your stance, how you will structure your presentation. You could bring it all together in a really powerful story that will ensure that people buy in to what it is that you're saying, and more importantly, they can have the support for your chosen charity. So go out on a limb, be as creative as you want to be, and make that impression. Now you would have seen the importance of visual communication for both presenters, supporters, and of course your audience. So as a reminder, ensure that your gestures are appropriate for your message. Use confident body language like the power stance. Ensure that your eye contact with the audience is engaging and not scary. And finally, the use of drama adds a creative element to your presentation. Here are some tips as to how you can use PowerPoint in your presentation. There are a lot of people who use PowerPoint and they think they're doing really well, but they have really rubbish presentations. But this is not going to happen to you, because I'm going to give you some tips as to how you can use it effectively. Okay, so when you're putting your presentation together, use no more than 5 slides. That's right, a maximum of 5. Think about the points that you want to make, but don't use more than 5 slides. And when you're compiling your slides, try and use a minimum amount of text, because if you try to put too many words on it, people will start to read it long before you say it, and that will lose the impact of what it is that you're trying to tell people. You have to remember that the slides, or PowerPoint, is there as a tool. It's there for the audience, and it's not there for a script for you. Now, sometimes you may forget a key word or something you're going to say, and that's okay if you glance back, but it's not there for you to just stand up and read it to people. It's only there as a support to what you're saying. Now, the charity you work with will probably have a logo. If they do have a logo, include it on your slides so those who are listening to you and watching the slides know specifically what charity you're referring to. I'd also say that it would be really good to have on your slides the names of all the members of the team that are taking part in this presentation. It's a great way for making your audience be aware of who's giving that presentation. And the last thing I'd say about your presentation is make sure any facts and stats that you're going to have as part of your presentation, you include those on the slides. I assure you that if you use those tips, your presentation will definitely have the impact that you desire. We want to thank you for being a part of this project. At First Give, we are passionate about inspiring a generation of young people to use their time and talent to improve their community. So go out there and be amazing.